Live from the CBS Bay Area studios, this is KPIX 5 News.
Now at noon, the beginning of a final farewell to former President George H.W. Bush. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Michelle Griego. Right now, the casket of former President Bush is on its way to Washington, where it will lie in state in the rotunda of the U.S. Capitol. The 41st President of the United States died Friday night at the age of 94. CBS reporter Nicole Killian looks at how former colleagues are remembering him.
The casket of former President George H.W. Bush received a military send-off at Ellington Airport in Houston en route to Washington Monday. His son, President George W. Bush, and former First Lady Laura Bush led the family onto the plane, which is being called Special Air Mission 41 for the trip.
He saw the world, not just the country.
On CBS this morning, former Secretary of State Colin Powell, who served as President Bush's chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff during the first Gulf War, remembered his former boss.
He would not make some jump decision out of nowhere. He would think it through and then decide what was best for the country, but not only what was best for the country, what was best for the world.
In an interview with 60 Minutes, former President George W. Bush says his father's legacy will grow with time.
I think he's going to go down as the greatest one-term president ever because of his foreign policy, deftly handling the end of the Cold War, for example, reunification of Germany.
Former President Bill Clinton, who beat Mr. Bush in the 1992 presidential election, recalled their bipartisan bond.
It's been one of the great joys of my life, my friendship with him. Our arguments were good-natured and open, and we continue to debate things all the way up until recently.
President Bush will lie in state in the Capitol Rotunda until Wednesday. Then a motorcade will transport his casket through Washington to the National Cathedral for a state funeral.
Afterwards, his body will be flown back to Texas for a public viewing and private funeral before being buried Thursday. Nicole Killian, CBS News, Capitol Hill.
A live look now at Joint Base Andrews, where the casket of President Bush is scheduled to arrive in just about 30 minutes. There will be a ceremony and a motorcade escort to the Capitol. One image getting a lot of attention today is this photo of President Bush's service dog, Sully, sitting by his flag-draped casket at the funeral home in Houston. The Labrador will be placed with a new veteran family at the former president's request. And we will have continuing coverage of the nation's farewell to President Bush right here on KPIX 5 and KPIX.com.